African American brother goes back to Africa to learn the truth about history.
I have some Ghanaian in me.
Did you check your DNA?
Yeah, I have some. Now I do. When I did African ancestry, I linked to the Temene tribe in Sierra Leone, and that's how I was able to get the citizenship. But it's like the warmth of the people here in Ghana, and it's Sierra Leone also. I mean, it's just a different kind of connection that I have. Just here for some reason.
What really inspired your travels in Africa?
The fact that I had waited all of my life and I didn't. And the propaganda that they teach us in America is to stay away. Everybody's sick. Everybody's dead.
Greetings to your great people in diaspora. So many of us were taught in school that
dying, everybody's going to get kidnapped. That's what they tell us. And so they really make it unappealing. And then when I came, I figured out how much I was deceived. And I just kept wanting more and more and more and more. And that's why I said I have to explore the whole continent. I love South Africa. I love Tanzania. Every place I've been, I've fallen in love with.
I mean, let me understand. You were deceived.
Mm-hmm.
Now you're here. What are the things that they told you that when you came here, you realized that, oh my goodness, this was not like that?
Well, they told us that the people in Africa, because you know they made it all one, don't like us. And I have not experienced that. I've experienced hospitality, first-class hospitality. I've experienced people expressing genuine love, going out of their way to help me. They see what I'm doing on YouTube and they appreciate the recognition and the acknowledgement that I'm giving them. So it's all of what they have been telling us has been false. I mean, if anything, where I get the pushback from is back in the States.
I mean, I want to say that welcome to Ghana. And let me know, how long have you been watching my videos?
Oh man, how long has it been now? At least a year and a half. At least a year and a half. And just following your journey and what you've been doing, again, you've been transcending generations and you're willing to say things. And sometimes it's controversial. But you call it how it is.
Exactly.
And that's what we appreciate. And I think the continent as a whole is benefiting from what you're doing because you're exposing people to parts of Africa that they would never think about, like the piece you did about Namibia.
Mm.
You know, people would never even, they don't even know Namibia exists because they think Africa is one country when it's a continent with 54 different countries.
Currently you're in Ghana. How many places in Ghana have you been so far? I mean, part of Ghana that you've
been All right, I've been to Accra. I've been to Kumasi. I've been to Tamale. I've been to Tema. I've been to Cape Coast.
Mm.
I'm here in Takoradi now.
How is life in Ghana in general?
Oh, I love it. You know, one of the things is that coming from the States, you deal with